Jesus.
Ed, there's water in the kitchen.
I just gotta show this. It's not possible. These are holes in our lap. There's a river. Literally a river. And the valley. Oh my God. Once in a lifetime thing here. You wanna see that back path?
You want to see our kitchen? Oh, our kitchen is brown.
Wow.
It's a disaster. Look at the valley.
Come on, Anna, let's get back. We'll assess damage in the morning.
Ed, there's water in the kitchen.
There's water everywhere, Anna. What are you doing? You're filming.
Oh, that's not fair.
I'll cover myself up a little bit.
I just put Charles to sleep and then I came outside to see where you, like, I couldn't see you.
I've been vlogging, Anna. I know you told me to go and talk on Stephanie's live chat and watch what's going on Stephanie's live chat, but I couldn't. Do you want to have a look?
Yeah. My God, there's water everywhere. The road has washed.
No, that's nothing.
What do you mean?
Look in the field.
My God.
This is Lagos in June. This is the first time I've ever seen this. Been here 20 years. So we have had major rain. We have what I can only describe as like mud slide coming down the valley there, off the vines. We have a nice neat little waterfall down the back here. And this is unheard of. We have never had rain like this. Obviously the culverts can't deal with it. And these aren't culverts we built, these have been built maybe 50 or 100 years ago. There's a bridge down here, it's just all pouring around the bridge. There's mudslides up there, I can see them coming down from the vines again. Don't get me wrong, it's not a mudslide that's going to take a house out or anything like that, but there's a hell of a lot of clearing up to do. Flashes of lightning all around. Whoa. Yeah, this we've never had this before. Where the road is, there's a river. Literally a river. Oh my God. This is unbelievable. God knows what kind of disaster we're going to have at the Chateau. I mean, we've had no electricity for a while. We've had lots and lots of rain coming in the house. The tiles just couldn't cope with it. Oh my God, never have we ever had this kind of water on the top. I can't even get around there. Huge amounts of water on this terrace. So I started filming again in the courtyard. This is just unbelievable. Literally a river at the front of our house. Parked my car under the archway to make sure I didn't get any hailstone, but hailstone was the least of our worries. Like I say, 20 years we've been here, never had anything like this. I've had texts come through telling people to watch out for themselves and listen to the government. I think there's some kind of natural disaster going on. For us, I think we've been very, very lucky. We have water everywhere, we have stuff to clean up, but you know what, we're high up, it doesn't matter. Okay, now the pool's got a little bit dirty, but that's easily fixable. Well, so we have rivers coming down our valley. There's just nothing you can do when you get this much water. Absolutely nothing to do. It's got this kind of muddy water coming everywhere. Running down the steps. Filling up the lake. Wow. If Thank God we're on high ground. I'm going to head back because it's still a bit dangerous out here. Let's put it in perspective, it's not really been raining, it's spitting now. It's not really been raining for about 10 minutes. And we've just got a massive river going past the front of our house. It's just unbelievable. Just finished working on Dad's place and there's mega water right at the front of theirs where we have a nice little grid system. Wasn't going to cope with this kind of water. There's an ominous kind of flow of water sound down here, like a waterfall. My main worry is the road in, because there's a wall holding back what must be water. We normally get a little bit of water behind our road in, but there I think we're going to have a hell of a lot of water. I mean, this is just unbelievable. It's like a river. I don't know what this big bulge is here. I think that might be the edge of our path in. I think I'm going to walk around because this isn't worrying me that much. I've got wet feet already, so that's not the end of the world. We have a river going there. Chickens are nice and dry. This is where I was worried about. Oh my God. This is like 6 foot, 7 foot deep. It's pretty much like a dam. And what I'm worried about is this wall here. Oh my God, look at the river. This has to be some kind of natural disaster. It's too much water not to be. I'm trying to make my way down this path. I haven't got much room. I'm in the dressing gown. Oh jeez, it's cold water. There we go, I'm in the middle. But I just got to show this, it's not possible. These are holes in our path. About 2 foot deep holes in the path. It's literally like a waterfall down here. I was wondering where what I'm about to show you came from, but that was my answer. Basically, our path has washed away, as well as lots of stones and mud in the vines that's washed away. But if you look, my God, we've got a lot of work on our hands to clear this up. Like I say, never ever seen anything like this. 20 years we've been here. I'm sure if I go and ask the guys up the road, they'll not believe the amount of water we've got pouring at the gorse. And they've lived here all their lives. There are many waterfalls coming from the path. On the plus side, it is quite nice to see these waterfalls, but they're not meant to be here. I mean, just look. Wow. I don't think this is going to be possible to clear up by hand. I'm going to get back in soon because Anna's going to wonder where the hell I've got to. She was asking me if I was on the live chat on Stephanie's vlog tonight. I've got better things to be doing. Sorry, Stephanie, I love your vlogs, but this is a once-in-a-lifetime thing here. Just wonder what's going on down in the village where the river is. I just hope that everyone's safe down there. I suppose for now, the wall's holding on the pool, which is good news as well, because I wouldn't like to have to rebuild a wall. This is just unbelievable. We have like, it's as if some kind of dam's burst. Obviously there's no dams in Holt. My next worry is the lake, I suppose. I mean, I thought it was going to be salvageable, but looking at that, I think it's a start again jobby. God, again walking through about a foot of water to get to the lake area. There's no way in this world that the pipe I've got at the end of this lake is dealing with all this water. And again, I'm worried about the actual barrier on the lake. I did clean this culvert out last year, which is great, but I mean, even so, it's just not possible to cope with it. Again, I'm walking through about a foot of water with quite a strong tide on it. I just can't believe it. It's just so much water. There's that valley again, or should I say the Garonne. I'm going to have to call a friend in a minute, Eric, and see how things are down the road. I suppose if there's problems down there, they could probably do with every single hand they've got. So, or even I have some of the gendarmes' telephone number, I'll maybe even call them, because there's no way in this world that there's not a disaster down in the village. It's just not possible. I want to come and have a look at my road at the side. Wow. Well, I suppose on the plus side, no walls down so far, and it doesn't look like we're going to have a lot more rain, so we have got away with it fairly unscathed. It's mainly the paths that have been absolutely and utterly destroyed. So on that vlog about, for you guys, it's probably about 5-10 minutes ago, this was where the river was going, and it has washed everything away. To be honest, I can do a lot of work, but I'm wondering now to myself if this is some kind of insurance claim, because I mean, how do I go about fixing this road? It's just a mammoth task. I suppose it's take stock tomorrow morning and call the insurer, see if there's anything that we can do about it. Don't forget, it's only myself and Cyril working at the Chateau. It's not, just not going to be, it's not going to be possible to clear this up quickly, that's for sure. That river's gone. The river and the culvert's gone. I wonder how the top terrace is faring up. It's still a bit of a mess. I wonder whether this has worked tonight. It was a couple of weeks that we did that. I wonder whether we got a lot of water in the reception room down below. We'll assess all damages tomorrow. I mean, God, it was right up here. I'm going to have a little sneaky peek in the Chateau, make sure. Kind of bone dry. It looks a bit wet in here. Somehow water's got in the kitchen. Oh my God. Oh, I know what that is. That'll be this door here. A little bit of water in the kitchen. I can cope with that. Thank God we've not got like a foot of water in here or anything. No, everything's fine. Don't worry, guys. Chateau the Gorse will survive.
My God, there's water everywhere. The road has washed.
No, that's nothing.
What do you mean?
Look in the field.
My God. Oh my God. So what, you came out dressed in your nightgown?
Look.
To stop the flood.
I'm a French local country bumpkin now. If I want to go out in my nightgown, I'll go out in my nightgown. This, when I came out here,
yeah,
had 6 inches of like 15 centimeters of water here.
My God, so I bet.
Did you know that the Gorse had waterfalls?
No.
It did well, now.
Well, we have a mini one, but we don't have a proper one.
Oh, we do, Anna.
Oh my God.
This had about that much water.
Oh God.
Here. Yeah, no, that's nothing. When you watch the vlog in the edit, you're just going to be blown away.
This.
I had to stop and put the chickens away in the coop. The silly things were still out.
They were taking a bath.
I thought, what are they doing out? They're still under the coop.
Were they singing in the rain? Well, oh my God.
Here,
yeah.
Again, a foot of water, a river, a foot of water. Literally 15, 20 minutes ago, this had a river here.
Can't believe it.
I was talking about the pump.
Yeah.
I was talking about this. Have a look at the path down. See what you think of the path down.
Oh!
Keep coming. What do you mean?
This was like nice.
Wait! That's nothing. Look.
There's like water.
It's 2-3 foot.
Yeah.
I had to jump over ravines and come to here. Look down here, there's nothing left of the path.
Oh
gone.
My God!
It's a hole. If I had fallen in that, I'd have got a little bit wet, you know.
Yeah, a little bit wet, you would have broken something. Oh my God!
just to put it in perspective,
the pool.
I walked across it.
It's gonna fall in.
Look.
Oh my god.
And that was perfectly flat before.
Yes.
We're not going further.
I walked with Emma here this morning.
Well, you know where all this has gone?
No.
Down in the valley.
Oh my god.
Wait. Did you know we have a dam?
No, we don't have a dam. Where on earth do we have a dam now? I can hear water. Oh, yeah. Oh, my God.
Oh. You know the field here, Anna?
Yeah.
It's about 6 foot down, isn't it? Or 4 foot, 5 foot down.
Yeah.
Not anymore.
What's that?
Water.
Oh.
It's like, how many yards? 100?
No, 50 yards into the field water. Get down there, I'm in about 4 foot of water. You know what? I'm shocked.
So all that I can hear is the water going down. Oh my god. I mean, it's a disaster. Look at the valley.
You know what? There is one thing you have to say.
What?
You know how normally the lake overflows, right?
Yeah, no.
When it has a little bit of rain in comparison. So we're like talking maybe an eighth of the water going in.
Uh-huh.
It normally overflows, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Since I fitted that pipe, it's not overflowing anymore.
Yes, yes. Sure. You've done an amazing job. Oh, mon dieu. So this is all underwater now. We have how many lakes now instead of one?
Two.
Or three?
I don't know. Lost count. We've got the Garonne in our valley anyway.
Yes. Oh, mon dieu.
Come on, Anna, let's get back. We'll assess damage in the morning. I was saying on the vlog, it may even be an insurance claim. You want to see that back path?
You want to see our kitchen?
Oh,
our kitchen is brown.
I know, but that's cleaning, that's mopping and cleaning, we can deal with that.
This is our apartment, and this is the state of our kitchen floor now. Yeah, and it's everywhere, and there's water here, upstairs. It's just a catastrophe. So next morning, we're just assessing the damage, well, at least in our kitchen. So this is our kitchen, guys.
This is our pigsty.
Pigsty? Why are you calling it? Oh, because of the mud?
Yeah.
So this is the state of our floor. It was full of water last night. And this is all the little kids area where they play. And look at it. And we're trying to, we have our cushions for outside. We're trying to move them. Because look at the state of the floor. It's just, but there's something, I mean, at least the sun is shining today. So hopefully it's gonna.
Look at this, Anna.
Don't, it's gonna drip there.
Oh, let me get rid of it quick.
Yeah. Yeah, no, it's a lot of cleaning. Go everywhere now. And we're gonna pretty much. Well, today's gonna be cleaning day for us. And yeah, we have a special machine we usually use for the next day of the wedding to clean the dancing area. Special power to powerful one, and today we're going to use it to clean our kitchen.
So what happened was there was a river at the front of our apartment, and at some time during the half hour that it was ravenous, it poured in through the door here.
Someone came in and then made a...
It might have even cut, I don't know how it... So I did make a few calls last night. Apparently the local village was... No problem.
No problem.
It's literally just us that got a real bad hit, which is a bit of a bummer.
But then again, it's just cleaning up. The big problem is that path down the side of the chateau is gone.
And the pool, which we'll have to...
But yeah, but that's cleaning up. I can deal with that. But I've been around the chateau, and the good news is zero problems in the chateau.
Oh, that's good. Cause
oh, was... apart from a little bit of mopping in the kitchen. Cause
so we've had water
in
the both kitchens.
So I checked the radar last night once everything had calmed down a bit, and we had, like, you know, you've got all these different scales. We had the red bit, which is like the worst you can have. So the red bit went over us very slowly, and then the storm turned and we got another second red bit.
It's a double.
Double dose. I think that was the problem. Plus it's not, it's been so hot. Everything's baked, and so the water just couldn't go in the ground. Instead of going in the ground, it all came to us. Oh. Emma, what's going on?
She maybe should get her latest shoes dirty. Because she's growing. And she has a little, I mean, new pair of little shoes.
Emma, I'm going to be using a machine and you're not going to like the noise.
Yeah, I know, it's your chair. I know. Emma. I know, it's your table and chairs. Okay, we'll take it in after, okay? Okay. Shall we put it in? Oh, I know you won't. Okay. Shall mommy clean the feet first and then we go? Okay? Come on, let's clean it. Okay. Shall we take it in? Yes? Oh, you're taking it in yourself, you little cutie. Are you going for the table? I know, it's heavy for you. Table? How's it going? You have to empty it?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, it's going alright. It's getting the majority away. Can't get underneath the cabinets.
Yeah, but that I can do with them off.
But as long as we get the majority of it away, it's just like a dirty day. The kids have been out playing in the mud or something. No, but the majority of it's done. Getting done with this machine, so... I reckon half an hour we should be back to normal, Anna.
Oh, that's good.
There we are, 80% of the rubbish gone within about 15 minutes. This isn't a sponsored advert for Karsha, but if you're ever like us, stuck between an insurance claim and a real mess, and you've got tile floors, hire one of these. Because it's just saved hours of mopping.
It does, yes, you're right.
Now I'm just going to get the mop, get the real thick stuff off from around the corners and where I couldn't get with that. Empty it and mop again, and we should be done. Anna.
You're very good at very, very resourceful.
You know, we didn't really need this with everything else we've got going on, and
no,
with, you know, weddings and Villeneuve and what have you. Well, it's one of those things, and you know what? Nobody's hurt, are they? Nobody's. There's nothing that can't be fixed with a bit of work. Or a lot of work.
I think more like a lot of work.
Oh, I've not done that bit. You see, you distracted me.
What do you mean I distracted? It was right in front of you. How on earth did that distract you? You were too busy trying to...
Come in, looking all hot, Anna.
You're joking. Okay, turn it over. So I've slept like 4 hours. I'm wearing my t-shirt that I used to wear when I was pregnant. And yeah, this is... I don't know, flip-flops, I get mud on my toes, I don't know how.
Is that does it for me? Muddy toes.
Whatever rocks your boat. So Inspector Emma is coming to check on Daddy's work.
Well, I've got all the filth, and it was filth out the corners.
Mm-hmm. Oh my god, the stink of the water there.
It's like the pool. Cyril's getting on with putting the stones back in the place, which should be about a good half hour's job. And then we can get on with other stuff.
Are we going to see cereal, Emma? You come in.
I'm going to mop the floor. We should be done with that floor.
Come on, Boo Boo. Let's go see cereal. Come on. Come on.
Whilst Anna's out, I just wanted to say that I'm concentrating on getting this kitchen back to normal, just because I know that Anna, Charles and Emma have been kind of perturbed by this. Charles was very upset when his bedroom had a lot of water coming in because the roof failed. He went to school today with kind of like a duffel jacket on, and I was like, well, what are you doing? It's not cold. And he even had a woolly hat on, so he was really scared. The teacher said, oh, that's him protecting himself. So it's really important I've got this back to normal. Anna's coming back in a second, so I think that should hopefully help Anna and Emma feel right too. And then I'm just going to have to work out from there. I've got a professional machine where I can clean Charles's bedroom with, because his carpet's sopping wet, and then work out from there. I'd just maybe do the stones outside the front door and things like that, so that when Charles gets back from school, he forgets about the problems we had last night. The other jobs are going to take a lot longer. Thankfully, I've got Cyril going on those now.
Ouais, il y a beaucoup d'eau. Alors, en ce qui concerne ses mains qui vient vérifier notre travail. So yesterday, because I've just redone like all the geraniums and they were ready to go on the window ledges, and I was ready to put them up. I'm glad I didn't, because they were gonna. I mean, it was windy as well, so you can just imagine all of the boxes on the floor. Where are you going, Bubu? Okay, come on then. And this is just as you go under the arch. Emma, no. Come on, Bubu. This is really sad, because yesterday this was beautiful, and then today all the roses have been destroyed. It's okay. We'll come back. Let's go. Do you knock knock? Come on then. I will open for you. In you go. You can have a look quickly at the kitchen in the oh my god, there's water. Give me a hand. Just be careful. Yeah, it's bad. No, rest at mom. Yeah, the kitchen floor is bad.
We all have our happy place. Emma's happy place is the third terrace. I'm checking on the fishes. Hopefully they're okay.
Even their water has had mud in. Can you see the fishes? Can you see them? We can't see them, can we, Em? No, on ne peut pas les voir. There's still a water level. That does look so good, yeah.
Let's go. Come on, best friend. Let's go see Dada, because Daddy's been working. Okay. Hey, Bunny.
Hi.
How's it going? Because you're doing the hard work.
It's just so hot. I've had to put the aircon on in the kitchen because it's that humid. I think it's all the inch of rain, the inch of water we had in the kitchen. But we're back to normal now in the kitchen, and we're gonna have to take our shoes off every time we come in because it's so muddy outside.
Yeah.
But look, kitchen's back to normal.
The kitchen does look good. I won't go too much further because I don't want you to say I'm not respecting your work. We're actually, I really hope that you're taking over and you're doing all the heavy cleaning.
Right, kitchen done. Let's go find that thing. Where's Emma?
Play with the cat.
Leave Hugo alone! Hugo! Is that your Huggy? Is that your little Huggy Doogie? Be nice to Hugo. Nice. Yeah, câlin, 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 câlin. Don't forget, Hugo is tiny. I know you're used to the dog. Yeah, he's your kitty cat.
Well, there is something good at least. The sun is out and we do have blue skies.
Is this the calm after the storm or the calm before the storm?
We had beautiful weather yesterday, and then it just
turned upside down.